So maybe to start, what's behind the kind of the gender switch? Is that obviously for storytelling, for a different way into the story?
I mean, for me, I just thought it would be much more of a challenge to do this. And I thought, I always loved that central relationship in the movie. But when I thought more and more about it, the idea of making it a father-daughter just felt more dynamic to me. And I'm a father of a daughter. And, you know, there's this sort of trope of daddy's little girl that I think this show sort of explodes because she's anything but. And we've really run with that. And I think I haven't seen a relationship like this, at least in the shows that I'm watching. So, you know, it felt more exciting, more dynamic, and not so tried and true, to be completely honest with you.
Is the Nightingale Killer the main mystery of the show, or will there be more afterwards?
There are other mysteries and conflicts and issues that are either explicitly brought up in the pilot or hinted at. And I think that one of the fun things about the show is why we sort of have this propulsive mystery with sort of a ticking clock. We have all these other complications standing in the way, and that's been lending itself to episodes that are pretty unpredictable, and that there's no one template for the show. And while it makes it a little trickier to break these stories, I think it's ultimately going to be more rewarding to watch.
Why did you want Peyton? Why did she fit the role?
I'm sorry?
Why did you ask Peyton? Peyton, yeah.
I don't think I saw any actor for that role that came remotely close to the, I'll call it gravitas or pathos that she brought to the role. From the second she came in for her first reading, she had fully inhabited this strong, mature, complicated woman. And it was exactly what we were looking for in the character. She was brilliant.
Why 1986? I guess theoretically you could have chosen
to be. Like 1906? Why 1996? That was pretty much for practical reasons, in that if we didn't want our main characters to be, in 2016, to be too old, how far are you going to go back? You know, so it's like, and then 96 felt like just different enough era-wise to be able to pull it off. You know what I mean? It's a bit of a tricky generation to hit just because it's not so singular like the 80s, you know what I mean, or the 70s and 60s, but it worked very well for thinking about the show moving along.
Can you talk about the format of the show?
I'm sorry?
Format.
Right. Right. So I would consider the show to be, you know, of three parts. You know, you have a mystery or police drama, you've got the family drama, and you have the genre part of it. And they're sort of all mashed together because these are really, in my mind, very grounded, ordinary people who are stuck in this extraordinary situation. So everything sort of rears its ugly head when they're least expecting it. When they're on the police part of it, genre rears its head because they've screwed something up. And of course, these are the only two people who actually know what's going on. So it plays havoc with their personal lives. That's what we actually have already seen in the pilot. So there's no one template for each episode, like I was saying. And again, I think there's a sense of unpredictability to each episode that hopefully people will get excited about. You know?
So in the new timeline, the father now dies in a car accident some years ago. Do you think in success in the end, she could eventually prevent the car accident, like in the movie Dennis Quaid ultimately stops smoking and shows up as an old man?
I think in success anything is possible, but you could see a world where down the road they might confront that very issue, but they might not confront it in the same way that you're thinking about it. It might not be as simple as it's portrayed in the pilot.
And in Success, you get a second season, would you shift each time period a year, each year? So eventually it's 2017 and 1997, 2018.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I don't know that we would necessarily jump a year. That's really going to be, it's story dependent. That you know, whether it's a direct pickup or not. Well, let's see where we end up. You know, that's not set in stone.
Can you talk about some of the challenges you had in converting the movie to the television show format?
Well, I'll tell you one success. We were concerned. We didn't want it to be confusing. And I think that we've succeeded. I think the sort of people are really along for the ride, and they're not thinking about the rules. And they're not really that confused about which time they're in, you know what I mean? And so on that, I'm very, very happy. I think one of the other challenges might be, actually, you know what? The cross-time communication and the butterfly effect, that's a challenge. But, yeah, it's challenging. But we never want people to feel like... they have to keep a rule book by their side. And I mean, it's like, I personally like the shows where the rules are sort of baked into the infrastructure and sort of the scaffolding of the show, but not that you have to be reminded of the rules every other scene. You know, those are the genre shows that I like. And that you're going along with the ride. You will pick up on what the rules are, but we're not going to spell them out for you, because I think we have a lot of faith in our viewers, and they've seen these kind of shows, and I don't want to slow them down from the actual story.
Time travel seems to be an element in a handful of new shows, at least.
It sure does.
Yeah. Why do you guys think that is?
I have no idea. I honestly have no idea. I know our show, you know, there's an element of wish fulfillment and the idea of having a second chance, you know what I mean? And then that second chance going completely haywire, that I think was one of the appeals to me for the show. Why there's so much time travel, you know, I'm sure there's out something about the times we're living in and maybe people looking to escape, I don't know. I was drawn mostly by this central relationship. I mean, that's what drew me.
And ours was developed 2 seasons ago, yeah, so right. We were ahead of the trend.
Are you bummed that there are a bunch of other shows with this element in it?
I think ours is so distinct and unique.
Because ours isn't really time travel. Yeah. You know what I mean? And ours is, you know, not that others wouldn't say theirs aren't character based, but ours feels very grounded and relatable, and I think unexpectedly emotional. And, I've got like a cold, dark heart, and somehow that, like, you know, they wrung every bit of emotion out of it. So to me, it doesn't feel like the other ones out there.